It's amazing to me that you come into an auditorium and you see students instantly knowing their attention and knowing their vote and voice is perfect. That's what's really making a major difference and an impact on our school right now, is the voice. And today is one of the proudest moments as you can stand here as a principal, as a award that you can give out today, knowing how these students have earned this with their academics. And knowing the power of the future that we're charged with to provide for our generations. Because this generation will be the ones that's going to be taking of our care of our generation. And I want to tell you what I'm very confident in saying. This group of individuals that's graduating is very capable, and they're going to do amazing, great things that we're going to be sitting back and enjoy watching. The things they do every day, that's more than amazing. There's so many days that I feel like I'm not the principal and I'm the student. And the students are teaching me every day. And I feel like the teachers will say the same thing. As more technology becomes into the part of the classroom, and the more that I see the students doing, they definitely give me lessons. I've learned that I don't use Twitter. I've learned it was Twitter. I learned that real quick. I've also learned that it's Snap something. They finally taught me it's Snapchat. And the other things is, I've learned one valuable lesson, that when our generation learned how to use Facebook, that this generation dodged it. I've learned that very well, because we can't keep up with them. They're that smart. But I want to do something real quick right now. We're on Facebook Live, and I think it's very important that we show the support that we have in this community for our students. Mr. Vice is going to go around and show them what we have here today. And the message that we send out to the world about the power of academics in Menifee County High School. But I do want to thank everybody for being here. Today is a huge day for our seniors. For the freshmen sitting in the stands, from the sophomores sitting in the stands, and the juniors. You'll see the power of this moment. This is the moment where you see these seniors set a goal that they're going to go on, because Menifee County High School is not the end of your education. This is the beginning. Our job is to prepare you for the next step. And you're going to see that power, because this day is going to come for you very shortly. We expect every student to come here and sign their name. That's the expectations that we have. That's not the expectations for me, not just for me, your teachers, the staff here. This is the expectation on you from your families and your community. With that being said, I'd like to turn the program over to our guidance counselor, Ms. Esther Campbell. Can we give her two claps of the room?
Thank you all for joining us today for such an important occasion. And it's happy and exciting, and it's also very, very sad. We hate to see our students leave, and it's sad for parents too, I know. But we come here to celebrate accomplishments. And we have all several universities here. We want to thank all our guests. We have scholarship presenters. And we'll start out with college signing. And when that's complete, we're going to move on to recognizing our seniors who are transition ready, giving them their baby stalls to their graduation, and all the other clubs that they've been a part of. And to list all the scholarships, they've really done well with pulling in money for scholarships. So thank all of you all. And as they come down to sign, if the family wants to snap pictures, they can do that with the people who are here, so you have a good picture for that. With that, we'll get started. Our first graduate is Zachary Rose. And he's with Alice Lloyd down there on the very end.
Okay, let's say a little bit something about Zach. He is going to Alice Lloyd. pursue engineering and play a little baseball. So we're really proud of Zach.
Our next graduate we want to recognize is Ms. Hayley Phillips. She'll be attending the University of Kentucky. Thank you. Our next graduate attending EKU will be Harley Short. Harley will be studying information technology, and Alexis will be studying nursing. Our final graduate who will be attending EKU is Ms. Mary Webb. We have one graduate who couldn't be here today that will be attending Berea College, and that's Mr. Eric Meade. We also have one graduate who could be here today. Olivia Hess will be attending Bluegrass Community Technical College. Okay, our next two groups are the larger groups that we're signing. We have a number of students going to Morehead State University and a number of students who will be attending Maysville. So we will probably call you down in groups of three or four you signing. They go back and you'll have a few more. Let's start with Maysville. We have Ms. Caitlin Back, Ms. Cora Beverly, Mr. Chase Brown, and Mr. Ryan Creech. In the interest of time, we're going to call some Morehead State people. If you want to have a picture taken with your family, they can come down also. Our first group of Morehead State, Emily Back, Colby Baldwin, Dalton Barnett, and Luke Brewer. Our next group of Maysville graduates, Brianna Ferguson, Kiara Farrell, Adrian Gross, and Caitlin Hunt. Thank you.
Our next group of MSU, Chandler Brown, Will Clemens, Zane Crouch, and Leah Dotson.
You have a student on the EKU that want to get family pictures with his name on the table. You can do that right now as well.
I'm sorry.
Joseph Murphy, Tessa Pieros, John Saint, Caitlin Salinas.
Very generous with our students.
I want to announce that NAF Care, we had 11 seniors receive the NAF Care Scholarship, which is a $5,000 scholarship. Ordinarily, it's given to 10 students. We had 11 students apply, and they agreed to give us an extra one this year. Our NAF Care recipients, I'm just going to read their names. Emily Patrick, Mara Walker, Jake Manning, Tom Barnett, Ben Deere, Will Clemens, John Sane, Joe Murphy, Lane Smallwood, Callie Mullins, and Zane Crouch. This year's Chamber of Commerce scholarship winner is Chase Brown. Our Clark Energy Scholar winners this year were with Emily Patrick and Mara Walker. Mountain Telephone Scholarship winners was Chandler Brown, Lainey Smallwood, John Sane, and Dalton Barnett. The Joe Tackett Memorial Scholarship was given to John Sane. Jacob Lawson won the Kentucky Fame Scholarship. We have a very special guest here, Jamie Spencer, to present the Disabled Veterans Scholarship. This scholarship was given to Ms. Haley Salinas. and Dalton Barnett. The next scholarship that I have is from the Menifee County Retired Teachers Association, and that goes to Jacob Peck. These were given to me as I came in here this afternoon. They are cards from Farm Bureau for some of our graduates. Dalton Barnett. Sarah Wilson. Haley Phillips. Stephen Evans. Kyle Helton. And Mary Webb. This concludes the presentation of our scholarships and our college signings. Mr. Bates, what's saying?
Those official presentations that we're getting ready to make from the colleges. First, we have Alex Lowen, Mr. Seals.
Good morning, my name is Jordan Seals. I'm an admissions counselor with Alice Lloyd College, and today we have one student. He'll be receiving two scholarships. The first will be the Appalachian Leaders College Scholarship, and then the Dean's Distinguished College Scholarship. So the first scholarship is the Appalachian Leaders. At Alice Lloyd College, our students not only learn and grow as intellectuals, but they receive a character-based education that infuses them with a sense of purpose and a vision of what they can do to help others. Today, I stand here to recognize one of these future Appalachian Leaders as the recipient of the prestigious Appalachian Leaders College Scholarship Award. And what this award is for is guaranteed tuition for up to 10 semesters. Along with being a resident of the 108 service county areas, he also had to meet the requirements of academic excellence, completed the required interview process, and he was selected to attend Alice Lloyd College. So on behalf of the Board of Trustees, President Joe Allen Stepp, and the faculty and staff at Alice Lloyd College, we are pleased to present this scholarship to Zachary Rhodes. Also, I would like to present him with the Alice Lloyd College Dean's Distinguished Scholarship. As I said before, the Appalachian Leaders College Scholarship is guaranteed for up to 10 semesters or 5 years. Along with this Dean's Distinguished Scholarship, he will have awarded $1,000 towards his books, which is $500 per semester. He is guaranteed acceptance into our Canaan College program at the University of Kentucky, and he will be a member of the Alice Lloyd College Leadership Program, our honors program. And along with those requirements I mentioned earlier, academic requirements and things like that, he had to have a 3.5 core GPA and had a 28 or higher on his ACT score. And he also had to show exemplary character consistent with traditional Christian values, as evidenced by outstanding leadership, strong words of work ethic and community service. So again, I'd like to present this on behalf of the Board of Trustees, President Joe Allenstedt, and the faculty and staff of Dallas Floyd College. We are pleased to present this scholarship to Zachary Rhodes. Wish you all success in whatever you do. And just for me personally, I'm a big WWE guy, so I want to hear the two claps and Ric Flair shout myself, all right? So can you give me one? All right, y'all have a good day, and God bless.
Thank you. Next, we have Ashley Banks. Ashley Banks will be receiving the Dean's Scholar Award. Next, we have Ms. Chandler Brown. Chandler will be receiving the Dean's Scholar Award. Next, we have William Clemens. William will be receiving the Residence Hall Leadership Scholarship and the Alumni Scholarship. Next, we have Mr. Zane Crouch. Next, we have Mr. Jacob Peck. Jacob is receiving the Commonwealth Scholarship and the Alumni Scholarship. Tessa Quarles, I'm not sure if she's here, Residence Hall Leadership Scholarship. Next, we have Mr. John Sain. John will be receiving the Alumni Scholarship and the Meeting and Issue Bookstore Award. Scholarship. And the diversity scholarship is full tuition. tuition for all 4 years, so great scholarship. Next, I'm going to give out the Friends of Cajun Scholarship. This is an institutional foundation scholarship with Morehead State University. It's $1,000, and the scholarship goes to Myron Walker. This scholarship is awarded to a Menifee County High School senior who is attending Morehead State University and meet the scholarship criteria. An essay was provided expressing the character traits of Rose and Harold Bryant: charity, service to others, pride in Menifee County, and love of family. The first recipient of the $5,000 Rose and Harold Bryant scholarship is Dalton Barnett.
And hope that everything you've ever dreamed of comes true for you.
I am honored to present the Walker Company Scholarship today. That is a $3,000 scholarship for the 2018-2019 academic year to Mrs. Caitlin Back.
Dawson.
Kyle Helton. Joe Murphy. Emily Patrick. Kaylin Hunt. Yeah.
Allison Likens. Alan Mays. Casey Peck. Carly Pruitt. Tessa Kieros. Blake Rose. Kaylee Celez. Harley Short. Brandon Sloan. Lainey Smallwood. TJ Haley Ward. Noah Ward. And Sarah Wilson. At this time, Ms. Valeria, Ms. Cal will come forward, present the baby stones.
We're going to do the baby stones. First, I want to bring up the president of the Beta Club. I want to, I guess the old saying, not him, and he's going to be able to present the awards to his fellow classmates. Mr. Casey Peck.
Oh my God. Our next lady in the red is our secretary, Ms. Taylor Nunn.
Thank you.
Mr. Joe Murphy. Mr. Chase Brown. And Mr. Jacob Lawson. And the last one is to Mr. Stephen Evans. And now, certificates of skill attainment. These students have passed the COSA test by the Kentucky Department of Education on being occupational ready. In animal science, first, Mr. Kenneth Welch. In animal science, Mr. Noah Ward. Animal science and transition ready. We got the scores in. Mr. Jacob Lawson. Animal science, Miss Olivia Hess. Animal science, Mr. Stephen Evans. Animal science, Miss Latasha Cockerham. Animal science, Ms. Marissa Brown. Certificate of Skills Attainment. The next category is Ag Power Structured Technical Systems. Mr. Noah Ward. Mr. Matthew Trusty, Ag Power Structured Technical Systems. Power Structure Technical Systems, Sawyer Patrick. Infrastructure Technical System, Mr. Joel Murphy.
Hey, Phillips actually passed it last year as a junior.
I made another mistake, and I'm going to tell you, this is year one, and I wish I could say this is only like two or three mistakes I've made all year, but I'm making them every day. And I want to, but the only thing I learned about a mistake is I try to play the world to fix it. I didn't mess up on the transition rating with Mr. Lawson earlier, and I apologize about that. That was my mistake. I have another mistake that I made, which, like I said, I'll never tell it to anybody, but I try not to admit them as much for like probably every 5 minutes. But I did this one on the beta club. It was Mr. Jordan Fugue.
So looking into many different medical projects throughout the community. So this is a very good club. If you wanted to work in the community and get some community hours, this is a great job. Thank you. The next group I want to announce is our rural health scholars. If you are a rural health scholar, please come to the floor. Sadly, this year, not one student applied for rural health scholars, and I want to put that charge to you. If you are thinking about going into the medical field, rural health scholars is a scholar program where these individuals have got to work with paraprofessionals and professionals in the medical field and decide if they want to go into the medical field or not to go into the medical field. They represented Menifee County the last couple of years, and we're very proud of them. Thank you very much.
This time, the next course being presented is the ETS, that is the Educational Talent Search. Mr. Will Clements. Mr. Clements will be introducing those members. Joe Murphy.
Mary Webb, Haley Phillips, Al Helton, Kiera Burrow, Jordan Dugan, Emma member Gofor, Shandra Brown, anyone else in ETS? Yeah, I can't remember. Seniors. Oh, I'm a senior. Sorry, Stevie. Oh, I'm so bad. I'm so sorry.
This is the last speaker waiting for the next presentation. I'm going to announce the first person down and read off the names. This is our final awards that we'll be presenting to seniors. We'll be presenting awards to underclassmen and PDI sports following this. This is our student council court presentation. This right here is a group that's worked very hard. A lot of things going on this week. It's nice leaving here on a late night meeting. I go downtown. Can I get two claps and a whoop real quick? Now, thank you, thank you. And it was nice seeing them. If you notice all the downtown work they've done, all the downtown cleaning up, and all the things that they've done for not only the school here, but for the community. But the person going to be reading the names, and I'll read it, is Mr. John Sain. Mary Webb and Sarah Wilson.